start off dealing with the issues in your own college or your own campus, and then from there you'd be able, by participating in the work of the union, you'd be able to have access to the party's mainstream work and move up the ladder that way. If you're coming at a later stage of your life, as I said in the Congress Party today, if we do have, for example, something like the All India Professionals Congress, that becomes an opportunity for a tax-paying professional to have access to a political arena that the Congress Party offers. A third possibility would definitely be for a mid-career person to see if they can come into politics. That'll be somebody who's already got 15, 20 years work experience in their late 30s, early 40s, and they now want to come in. They would obviously be treated a bit differently, but they would not immediately be offered a ticket, as you say, unless they have a family background or something like that. What's more likely is they'll come in, attach themselves to a political leader, work in a back office initially, do research, do speech writing, come up with ideas, and from there, become noticed by the leadership and given opportunities. Jairam Ramesh is somebody who I believe came through that route. There are people like that. So there are these various ways that are available. You're right that it's much easier if you're the son of a former minister or a former MP, or the daughter of one for that matter. It's much easier in our country because along with that element in the gene pool, you're also inheriting name recognition. You're inheriting a patronage network. You're obviously inheriting your late father's or mother's supporters. And with all of that, you have a ready-made strength that an ordinary person would not have. That's unfortunately true. Even for someone like me, who had a fair amount of name recognition from my previous career and from my writing, I still had to work from scratch with the grassroots to get the party workers with me. For them, who was I? I was an outsider. They had not seen me around while they were struggling in politics. So that is a very important aspect to this whole thing that you have to bear in mind. It's not easy, but politics is also not only about being a candidate for election. It's also about contributing to the ideas, to the discussions, formulating positions, doing research, writing manifestos for parties, all these things which educated right-hand people are getting involved in more and more today. I think our politics is changing for the better, and there'll be more and more people like you come in. I heard all the nasty comments in the earlier panel, as you all did, and I can understand that. The entire middle class, to this day, my mother, until 2 years ago, my now late grandmother, were bitterly opposed to my being in politics. Their attitude was, you were the fellow who did well in the examinations, got a good career. Politics is for those who couldn't do well in the examinations. That's the usual attitude. And we have to go beyond that. If we don't want to be represented and ruled by people that we have to make excuses for, or that we're ashamed of, then we have to get involved ourselves. That's why I came into politics.